now you'll see that I've just took a slightly, probably about another 2 millimetres off the top of the leg, just so it gives me a higher point at the top, because personally that's just how I would like to have the leg left on, where it's a nice clear point, because this is always quite a hard area to get close because you've got so many whirls and excess skin. So by making it a clearer point here, it shows a clear difference from the pecs to the legs. We're now going to have a little play with the saddle cloth. Again, it is all about trusting the eye. Now with quite a big horse like this, it's very important to make sure that he's standing square. And I would also advise on a horse this height, when you're my height, is probably to grab a chair. Now everyone has preferences with saddle patches. If you have a dressage horse, you might want to go lower down the body, so that you've got a straight line behind the shoulder. If you've got a hunter, you might want to take all the hair off so that the sweat from the saddle patch doesn't create any skin problems later. And if you would like just to go for a jump saddle, then again, I would just draw a light line with my fingernail, just so it is symmetrical. There's no right or wrong with this, it is a purely personal preference. So I'm going to go and finish here. Purely because if we're out hunting, my saddle wouldn't come any further back than this point, which is a good wide hand in from the flank area. And I will start in the middle and go middle to front. Then if I'm pleased with this angle, I'll then go into the second half of my semicircle. That line there. It's symmetrical, it's smooth, so I'm now going to go and finish on my other half. Also step down from the chair to make sure that's straight and take another. Tiny little piece off there. Now as I've done this side, I will now go whilst I'm stood on the chair and will mark my line so that I can follow to make it identical the other side. So that's our legs and the saddle cover.